Hello everyone, this is Karan Singh and today in this video we will see a topic of English grammar, that is active and passive voice. This is its second part. If you all have not seen its first part, first of all go and see that. If you all have seen, then we continue with this video, okay? So let us come to start with today's lecture. So in this lecture I will tell you some other changes, because in first lecture I taught you how to change tenses from active voice to passive voice. So here in this lecture I will teach you all how to change modal auxiliary verb from active to passive voice. So modal auxiliary verbs are changed as following, okay? So let's see them. For that you all have to keep two structures in your mind for changing any modal auxiliary verb from active to passive voice, okay? So this is your first structure. If your active voice is found in this structure subject, then modal auxiliary verb first form and other word. So it is changed, you know, in this structure. First you will write object, then modal auxiliary verb, then be. You have to use after use be after modal auxiliary verb, then third form of the verb by, and your subject will be written in the last, okay? And if your active voice is found in this structure subject, there is a modal auxiliary verb, then have and third form and other word. So it is changed, you know, in with the help of this structure. First of all, you have to write object, then modal auxiliary verb. Here you have to write same modal auxiliary verbs, and then have, then been you have to use here, then third form by, and your subject will be used. So these are the two structures. If your active voice is found in this structure, so your passive is changed in with the help of this structure. If your active voice is found in this structure, so this will be changed in this structure, okay? So in first structure you have to use be, then third form, but in second you have to use been and third form. I hope these two structures will be in your mind. Okay, so now let's see some examples and try to see that how the changes are taking place. Read this example very carefully. I can solve this question. So can, this is a modal auxiliary verb, and here we have to apply first structure, because with modal auxiliary verb there is first form of the verb. So your object will be subject. This question can be solved by me. I hope how it has been converted from active to passive voice, that has been clear to you all. Means your object will be subject, your subject will be object, and your verb will be in third form, and just before verb you have to use be, okay? So this is the way to change active voice to passive voice of a modal auxiliary verb. Let's see some more example. Read these examples carefully. Ram should play the tabla. So the tabla, this is your object. It will become what? Your subject. So the tabla, same modal auxiliary verb, because here should has been used, so should will be applied. Then be played by Ram. Okay, I hope this example has also been clear to you all. Now see this example and read it very carefully. She may have written, you know, have and third form has come, so you have to apply second structure, a letter. So a letter, this is your object, it will be subject. A letter may have been, okay? So you here you have to use been, then third form, and by, then your subject will become as an object, okay? So what will be the passive voice of this sentence? A letter may have been written by her. She may have written a letter. A letter may have been written by her. I hope this example has also been cleared to you all. If it has been clear, let's see our next point, which is change from active to passive voice. This is third point, infinitive. So first of all, let's see what is infinitive. You know, 2 plus V1 form is called infinitive. Which form? 2 plus first form of the verb is called infinitive. So if in any sentence there is 2 plus V1 form, so how that will be changed from active to passive voice? Okay, so now we all are going to see that. Watch it carefully. Sorry. If there is 2 plus V1 in your active voice, then it will be changed as 2 plus B plus third form in passive voice. I hope this one has been clear, because this is very easy. This is active and it will be changed like this in passive. Let's see some examples based on infinitive. Read this example. C is to finish this work. So this work is to be finished. So here to finish, this is first form another word. First form another word. To be finished, this has been changed to plus B plus third form. Okay. So this is active as and this is your passive as of infinitive by her. So what will be the passive as of this sentence? This work is to be finished by her. Means C is to finish this work. This work is to be finished by her. I hope this example has been cleared to you all. Let's see a next example. Read this example. You have not to help him. So to help, this is also first form plus, sorry, 2 plus first form. It means infinitive. So he, him, it will be he. He has not to be helped by you. So this is your passive as of this sentence. I hope how it has been changed from active to passive, that is being cleared to you all. Let's see one more example on infinitive. We were to buy a house. To buy a house. So a house was to be bought by us. Okay. So this is your passive as of this sentence. I hope you all can change to infinitive verbs, 2 plus V1 form, from active to passive voice. Okay, let's see the next point, number 4, changes of kinds of sentence. So here in kinds of sentence we will learn imperative sentence. Okay, which one? Imperative sentence. And I hope you all know very well about this sentence. So kinds of sentence is changed as following. So let's see them one by one. As I told you all that in kinds of sentence we will see imperative sentence. So in imperative sentence there is the expression of order, advice, suggestion, and prohibition, request, proposal. So these all are the expression which come in imperative sentence. And now we are here to learn how these expressions are changed from active voice to passive voice. Okay, so let's see them one by one. So first of all, we will see order. If there is order in your active voice, so how it will be changed into passive voice? First of all, let's see what is the structure of order in active voice. So that is 2 plus V1. Okay. So 2 plus, sorry, this is not 2 plus V1. This is B1 plus other word. Okay. This is the structure of order in active voice. So if order comes, it is changed, you know, like this. You are ordered plus 2 plus B1. Okay, you can apply this structure. You are ordered plus 2 plus B1. And if there is another word, then you can use other word. So there is one more structure to change order from active to passive as. Okay, so let's see that structure also. First of all, let you all use let, then your object of order, then B, then a third form, and then other word. So you can use both the structure, this one and this one also. I hope you all can change order from active to passive voice. Let's see advice. This has the same structure, first form plus other word as an order. So this is changed, you know, with the help of this structure. If there is an advice, so you will change you are advised plus 2 plus B1 plus other word. Okay, I hope you all can change advice from active to passive voice. See the next expression, that is suggestion. What is the structure of suggestion in active voice? So it has the same structures as order and advice, B1 plus other word. So it is changed like this. First you have to write object of your active voice, then should, then B, and then third form, then other word. Okay, so these are the three structures, these are the three expressions, and how we will change them from active to passive voice. I hope these all concepts have been cleared to you all. If these concepts have been cleared, let's see some more expressions. Those are changed from active to passive in imperative sentence. Next one is prohibition. Prohibition, what is the structure? I think you all know what is the structure of prohibition in active as. So it has don't, V1 plus other word. Okay, you can say do not plus V1 plus other word. So if this structure is found in active as, so it is changed, you know, in this structure you are forbidden plus 2 plus V1 plus other word. Okay, so this structure you have to apply for changing prohibition from active to passive voice. Here you can also use one more structure. You are prohibited. You are prohibited plus 2 plus V1 plus other word. Okay, so this structure can be also applied for changing any prohibition from active to passive voice. If you do not want to use this one and just the second one, then you can use a third one, like you can use you are ordered plus not to V1 and other word. So this structure you can also apply for changing prohibition from active to passive voice. I hope you all can change prohibition from active to passive with the help of these three structures. Okay, let's see the next expression, that is request. So in request in active voice, which type of expression, which type of structure request has? It has please or kindly plus V1 and other words. So this is the structure of request, and it is changed, you know, with the help of this structure in passive voice. How request is changed? You are requested plus 2 plus V1 plus other word. Okay, I hope you all can change request from active to passive voice. Now let's see the last expression, that is proposal. How proposal is changed from active to passive? First of all, let's see what is the structure of a proposal in active voice. So it has this structure. It is started with let, then O, F, and S, then V1, and other word. Okay, so this is the structure. Here O, F, S is objective form of the subject. Okay, objective form of the subjects. So if your sentence, your active voice is found in this structure, is found with such type of you can say in such type of sentences, so it will be changed with the help of this structure. You will use first let, then object, you can say objective form of the subject, then be, third form, plus other word. Okay, so this is structures. This structure is applied while for changing proposal from active to passive voice. I hope these all six expressions have been clear to you all. How order is converted from active to passive, how advice can be changed from active to passive, how suggestions can be changed from active to passive, means with the help of these three structures, these are changed from active to passive voice. And next is prohibition. Prohibition is changed with the help of this structure. Request is changed with the help of this structure, and proposal is changed with the help of this structure from active to passive voice. I hope how these all expressions will be changed from active to passive, those all have been clear to you all. If it has, if these all have been cleared, let's see examples based on this, these expressions one by one. Number one, shut the window. So this is an order. There is first form plus other word. Okay, shut, this is first form, the window, other word. So this is an order. So what will be? You are ordered. You are ordered to shut the window. You are ordered to shut the window. Or you can use this structure also. Let, this object will be used here. Let the window, then you have to use be shut. This will be third form. Okay. So let the window be shut. This will be your active voice. So shut the window, this is your active voice. And what will be the passive voice of this sentence? You are ordered to shut the window, or let the window be shut. These two sentences are in passive voice of the first sentence. Okay. Let's see another example. Here is your second example. Read every day in the morning. So this is an advice. This is an advice. So how it will be changed? You are advised to V1 read every day in the morning. So you are advised to read every day in the morning. This is your passive voice. Okay. I hope these all rules which are being applied in these examples are being cleared to you all. Let's see the next example. Example number third, help the poor. This is a suggestion. Okay, this is what? Suggestion. So this is your object, it will be subject. The poor should be helped. Okay, so because this is the structure of a suggestion for changing from active to passive voice, I have just told you. Okay, let's see another example. Now here is an example based for on prohibition. Don't shout here. So do not shout here, or don't shout here. So it can be changed from active to passive by three ways. Number one, you are forbidden to shout here. Number two, you can apply You are prohibited to shout here. Number three, this can be also applied. You are ordered not to shout here. So whatever you want to use, you all can use, but I will recommend to use the first one. Okay. Now let's see another expression. This example is based on plea request. So what is the sentence? Please give me your pen. So how it is changed? You are requested to give me your pen. You are requested to give me your pen. I hope how these all are being changed from active to passive as are being cleared to you all. Okay, let's see next example and try to understand this example carefully. Let me do this work. Let me do this work. So let this work will come here. Let this work be done by me. So yes, this is a misspell by me. I hope how this sentence has been changed from active to passive. This has been also cleared to you all. Let's see our next point. Now number five. Watch it very carefully. Changes of a few verbs means now we are going to learn a few verbs which are changed from active to passive, but they do not come with this preposition by. Okay, they come with a different preposition. So here I will tell you a few verbs and which type of different prepositions are used with those verbs, and let you all note down somewhere and learn them. So these are those are like this: verbs active and passive. If no come, if there is a no, it comes with to. If there is annoyed, it comes with. If there is a surprise, it comes with at. Amaze, it comes with also at. Okay, so these are some verbs. No, with no, we do not use by preposition. Which preposition is used? To. Annoyed, with annoyed we use with preposition. Surprise, with surprise we use at preposition. Where? In passive voice. Okay, and amage, so with amage we also use at preposition. I hope these all verbs and which type of preposition are used with these verbs while changing from active to passive, that has been cleared to you all, and I hope you all have noted these verbs also. Let's see some more verbs and some more prepositions. So vex, it means to tease someone. Okay, to tease or to disturb someone. So vex comes with at. Shock, it comes also with at. Satisfy, it comes with. Interest, it comes with in. Please, it comes with. Okay, so these are some more verbs which come with different preposition. Means vex comes with at. Shock comes with at. Satisfied comes with. Interest comes with in, and please comes with. Okay, so these are a few verbs, and there are some more verbs, and I will just recommend you to all just go and collect such type of verbs and also note down which type of prepositions are used with these verbs and learn them. Okay, now we all are going to see some examples on the basis of these verbs, and we will see that different prepositions will be applied with these verbs while changing from active to passive as. So read this one. सी नोज मी, सी नोज मी. सो मी विल बी सब्जेक्ट, इट विल बिकम आई. आई दिस इज प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट, प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट टेंस. सो प्रेजेंट इंडेफिनिट टेंस गोज इन टू प्रेजेंट कंटिन्यूअस टेंस. सो हियर एम, दिस इज द हेल्पिंग वर्ब ऑफ कंटिन्यू. सो आई एम नोज विल बी इन टू थर्ड फॉर्म इन पैसिव एज. सो आई एम नोन एंड देन टू, दिस इज अ प्रीपोजिशन टू हर. If you say I am known by her, this will be incorrect. Okay, so with no, two prepositions come when we have to change the sentence from active to passive voice. I hope how and why two has been used as a preposition after no. That has been clear to you all. Let's see the next example. This is your next example. Read it carefully. Ram annoyed her. Annoyed her. And with annoyed, I told that which preposition comes with. So her will be C. This is past indefinite. And past indefinite goes into past continuous. C was annoyed with Ram. Okay. So with preposition has been used. But if you write by Ram, she was annoyed by Ram, so that will be incorrect. That will not be correct. Which one will be correct? This one, with Ram. Okay, this is not correct. I hope this has been clear to you all. See the next example. Read it carefully. The news surprised all. So there is a verb surprised. So all, this is also past indefinite, so it will goes into past continuous. All were surprised at the news. All were surprised at the news. Here at preposition has been used after surprise. But if you write by news, so that will be incorrect. All were surprised by the news, that will be incorrect. Okay, so mind it, which type of preposition you all have to use when these verbs come in your, when these verb come where in your active voice. So these these all comes with different prepositions, and you all have to remember these verbs and prepositions. Okay, see the next example, example number 4. He satisfied everybody. So everybody, because this is past indefinite, it will go where in future, past continuous. So everybody was satisfied with him. So with satisfied, there is which preposition comes? With preposition comes. Okay, if you use everybody was satisfied by him, that will be incorrect. Okay, this is correct. See the next example. Read it carefully. This book is greatly interested me. So me will be subject, I. This is present perfect. This is present perfect, so it will goes into present perfect continuous. So have been. So I have been greatly interested in this book, not by this book. Okay, if you write by this book, that will be incorrect. In this book, this will this is correct. See the next example. Here is your next example, example number 6. This news pleased everybody. So everybody was pleased with this news. So why this has been used? Because with please, this preposition is used, not by. I hope all these verbs and different prepositions have been clear to you all. And I also hope that you all have noted these verbs and its preposition in your notebook. Okay. So For today, it's enough, and this is the end of your this point, active and passive. I hope you all have enjoyed this lecture, and I also hope that each and every concept and points of active and passive voice has been clear to you all. But if you all have any doubt, any queries related to this topic, then you can just give me your comments. Give me your comments if you have any doubt about about this topic. So let you all write the comment where in the comment box. So that I can know that you have any problem or not. Okay, so see you all in the next video with next topics. Till then, bye bye.